Central High School event. Fort Pierce Central High School is located within the 4500 block of South, I'm sorry, 4100 block of South 25th Street, for those who do not know where exactly it is. Ready? We're here today to share the events that occurred yesterday at approximately 2 p.m. Members of the St. Lucie County Sheriff's Office Warrants Unit and United States Marshal Task Force were tracking a wanted fugitive, Marquise Jones, in the area of 3000 Avenue R. Jones, 39, was wanted on felony warrants that stemmed out of an incident that occurred in Port St. Lucie over the weekend. Those charges out of Port St. Lucie included aggravated battery, attempted aggravated assault with a deadly weapon, felony battery, possession of a firearm by a convicted felon, and false imprisonment. Once detectives located Jones and confirmed that he was standing outside the residence, detectives converged to make the arrest. Jones spotted several of the undercover vehicles moving in at his location, and he ran over to a vehicle in the front yard and retrieved the firearm. Jones began to flee the residence on foot. During that time, Jones ran to the back of the residence under a tree where he pointed his firearm at detectives. A sheriff's office detective assigned to the U.S. Marshal Task Force fired his weapon at Jones, but did not strike him. Jones was arrested and charged with possession of cocaine, possession of a weapon by a convicted felon, aggravated assault on law enforcement, and resisting arrest. The detective who discharged his weapon is on paid administrative leave, as is our policy. And let me just share with you, Jones is a very violent career criminal. This is his printout here. It is 81 pages long, of which he's been arrested 57 times for felonies, 44 times for misdemeanors, and he's been convicted of 12 felonies. So a very violent career felon, and we are thankful that none of our deputies or U.S. Marshals were injured in this incident. But the message is clear: if you point a gun at law enforcement, you can expect tragic results to occur on your end. And that's what happened today, but fortunately the suspect was not hit. So he'll probably be facing a long prison term if convicted of these charges. We do want to share with you, and I don't know how we're going to share it, the actual body cam video. Is this it here, Tanya?
No.
We're going to share with you the body cam video of the deputy who was involved in the shooting, as well as the helicopter video. Or are we going to just do the helicopter video? I can't remember what we decided. We're going to do both of them, and then you can look at it, and then you can ask me any questions you want.
Thank you.
Is that from a TV show, I'm assuming?
Mm-hmm.
It's a Tegra.
Yeah. Custom.
Or South Florida too.
We can probably take like a 50 or 55 and just ass swing.
Yeah.
Put it on it.
That's what I was saying, something.
And then it's queued up, ready to go for somebody who's hits the road.
You dropped the video though.
I have, it works.
No, I think they have access to it right in the draft.
I guess we're going to have to Dropbox it to them or email it to them.
They have some questions to ask
okay.
you while I try to get this
question. Okay, I'm here.
Who's our IT specialist in the room? Since we've been here, we got an update on the first incident, Central 2.
You do?
Yeah.
And it is?
An 83-year-old white male, not associated with anyone at the school. And he was found under a tree on the backside of the campus at Fort Pierce Central.
Can we ask questions about the...
Anything you want, go ahead.
Can you just give us a little, I mean, we can contact Port St. Lucie, but what was he accused of doing?
His charges out of Port St. Lucie stem from an incident over the weekend, including his girlfriend. So those charges include aggravated battery, attempted aggravated assault with a deadly weapon, felony battery, possession of a firearm by a convicted felon, and false imprisonment. So serious, serious charges. And even though we just have the warrant, we could presume that he probably held her against her will with a gun or a weapon of some kind and made threats while he was holding her.
People might hear if he's a 12 times a convicted felon,
mm-hmm.
why was he even out of jail in the first place?
You know, I can't answer that question. Mm-hmm. We ask the judiciary all the time, how do these people get out? And, you know, judges tell us they get sentenced, but prisons let them out. He should not be walking in our community, that's for sure.
Do you know how he had possession of the firearm?
Do not know that.
Was it registered to him? Was it, like, did he legally own it?
Don't even know that yet, do we? We're still investigating the firearm. And getting back, he's a 12 time convicted felon.
He just pointed the weapon, correct? He never shot?
He never shot at our deputy. He pointed the weapon while he was going over a fence, which you'll see if we get the video up, and our deputy fired at him.
And he was the only one arrested involving the Port St. Lucie charges?
No, that is correct. Anything else, Angela?
How important is it to have him off the streets again?
Well, it appears that he victimized someone who he professed his love for, his girlfriend, in such a manner that these felony warrants came out yesterday on him. And you could see he's been charged with 55 previous felonies, many of them violent. This is a violent individual. He does these charges over the weekend and finds himself with a gun yesterday when the police come to arrest him. So yeah, this is a violent individual. We want off our streets.
And around what time did this all go down?
Approximately 2 o'clock yesterday afternoon.
In Fort Pierce?
In Fort Pierce. 3,000 block of Avenue R.
Is that where he lives, or does he live in that area? Was he visiting someone in that area?
We got an answer for that? Don't know.
He didn't live there. He did, he, somebody gave him a ride, and he was waiting on a ride to the bus station.
There you go.
So where does he live?
I think he lived in Port St. Lucie.
He gives an address on 12th Street, but he told us he lives in Orlando.
And most of his charges are from the Orange County area. Orlando area.
Yes.
Previous charges, sorry.
So wait, with the 12th Street address, that's what he gave you, or that's what was on his...
I think that's what he gave us. However, he did clarify that he lives in the Orlando area. All these previous arrests occurred in or around Orlando in Orange County.
Can you also just to elaborate a little bit, just that decision, shoot, don't shoot, by your deputy, and it was just one round that didn't hit him, but I don't know how much you've spoken to the deputy in an interview yet, but just kind of what leads up to that decision of, I need to fire a round?
Well, you guys want to talk about it? Because you talked to the deputy. I mean, these deputies have to make these split-second decisions involving deadly force, and they have to weigh a lot of factors. In this case, they know they were going after somebody violent. They know he went to the car and grabbed a gun. And as he ran away, the deputy was smart enough not to shoot him running, even though he had a gun. But as soon as he hit the fence and turned with the gun toward the deputy, he fired 6 shots, not one, 6 shots. He missed him with all 6 shots. But the way the deputy told the investigators, the subject was running down a sidewalk. He was actually parallel him with his car. And then when he turned to run toward the fence, he stopped his car, had to get out of his car. By that time, the subject was jumping the fence and turning, and that's when he fired at him. A lot of decision making in a very, very short period of time, which, if you don't make the right decision, this deputy doesn't come home.
So was Jones in motion as he was turning, or did he stop and like was standing aiming the gun, or was he like running and just holding the gun loose?
He was jumping on the fence.
Is this it here?
It is, but every time I hit play, the TV is kicking off an error.
Okay.
I reset it and redid the pairing, so it may or may not work. We can try it.
You could take a look for your... This morning. Yeah, you could take a look again, but as he hit the fence, he turned to the deputy. Okay, well, we're going to just have to send it to him. He turned to the deputy with the gun, and that deputy had to make that life or death situation to shoot. And he did.
After the 6 shots, what did he do?
He actually jumped the fence, laid down prone, and put the gun out.
So the 6 shots stopped him?
Scared him to death to stop him, yeah.
And all those 6 shots were from that one detective?
Yep, and we've accounted for all those 6 shots, where they went. No one was hit by his bullets.
Was any property hit? Or?
Nope, we think the front yard was hit. So lessons learned, do what law enforcement tells you. Never aim a gun or a weapon at law enforcement, or else they're gonna protect themselves, and that's exactly what this deputy did. All right, thank you all. Oh yeah.
Okay,
sure.
It's Marquise Jones.